I'm down. Well, our last match of the afternoon, Kidambi against Sugiyato, will be very significant. So there, the three-time former champions from Denmark, Mathias Bo and Carsten Mogensen. In fact, they've been in four Super Series finals. Their opponents, the number three seeds, Kenichi Hayakawa and Hiroyuki Endo. Japanese pair against the Danes, the defending champions, Bo and Mogensen. Kenichi Hayakawa and Hiroyuki Endo. A beaten finalists 2 years ago at the Super Series finals, which were then staged in Shenzhen. Lost out in the final to the pair they've got to play today in this Group B encounter. The Olympic silver medalists from London 2012, the World Championship silver medalists from last year, bronze medalists at their home World Championships just a couple of months ago. Mathias Bo and Carsten Mogensen have virtually made this event their own. Four finals from the previous six Super Series finals. Only time they failed to reach the final of this event was last year, when they only reached the semi-final. And I say only with tongue in cheek, please don't take offence from that. Their form in this particular competition has been outstanding. There, the left-handed Mathias Bo, 34 years of age,
yellow.
From Odense.
Yellow.
I serve.
So the Danes have chosen to serve. So Kenichi Hayakawa and Hiroyuki Endo making their third appearance here. But this is extraordinary, isn't it? Seventh consecutive appearance at Super Series finals. It's only the Thailand mixed doubles pair who can emulate that, competing in all of the Super Series finals that have been staged. World ranking of two, up one place since last week. And I can tell you that they've played eight tournaments this year as far as the Super Series is concerned, finished the year ranked seven. Three titles, Korea, India, and French Open as well. So three finals from seven Super Series tournaments is pretty impressive. So to their opponents, Kenichi Hayakawa, 28 years of age, and Hiroyuki Endo, turned 28 2 days ago. Day before the Super Series finals started. Up one place on the world ranking this week to number three, have been as high as two. And they've been in two Super Series tournament finals this year. 11 Super Series tournaments of the 12. The only one they missed was the Australian Super Series, this Japanese pair. So great supporters of the tour, as indeed have the entire Japanese team. Now, as far as the Danes are concerned, yesterday they had to play the number two seeds from Chinese Taipei, Li Shengmu and Sai Chia Sin. Won in two straight games, 21-16, 21-16. And their opponents, Hayakawa and Endo, won their match against Liu Xiaolong and Chu Sihan, two straight games. So our court officials for this one, Rahana da Silva of Sri Lanka and Sukarja from Indonesia. So with both these pairs having played one match, one match, then this encounter could prove absolutely crucial within Group B.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Mathias Boye, Carsten Mogensen, Denmark. And on my left, Hiroki Endo, Kenichi Hayakawa, Japan. Mathias Boye to serve to Hiroki Endo, low wall, play.
So the three-time former champions, Mathias Boye and Carsten Mogensen of Denmark, nearest to us, the left and right-handed combination, getting this group match underway. Now this is the seventh meeting between these two pairs, and the Danes have won on the last two occasions and won five of the previous six. So presumably they must be overwhelming favourites. Last time they met, incidentally, was in the final of the French Super Series, and it was three games on that occasion. Danes lost the first game to 18 and then won very comfortably indeed, 21-9, 21-7. That's a great smash from Carsten Mogensen.
Good follow-up, very, very strong follow-up by Mogensen here.
That was a good shot from Mogensen. The little hold on the backhand. Fast and deep into his opponent's backhand corner. That one, that did the damage. Yeah, there it is again. Yeah, good rally.
Service over. 1-3.
It's all about the initiative. And the Danes had it here, but unfortunately, Mathias Boye missed that one, but it's all about the initiative.
Endlessly about how good the Danes are when they're on the attack. That's how they still have some frailties on their defensive play.
Hey. So we saw 4-3. Thank you.
That's a nice change of pace. Oh, I think the strings have gone in Bo's racket.
Gone.
Yeah.
Oh, that's fair luck. That was a good block by Matthias. He managed to control that one with a broken string. I think that was pretty good.
All.
Oh, he's breathing pretty heavily already, isn't he?
Yeah, it's a fast pace.
Oh, look at that. Ooh. That is magnificent from Kenichi Hayakawa.
5-4.
Ooh.
What disguise. What precision.
Yeah, and it dropped before the first line. That was a really good shot. Excellent shot.
So! 6-4.
They've been in a total of 6 Super Series tournament finals of this Japanese pair. And that was a little bit lucky, wasn't it? But they're still looking for their first
ever title.
And at some stage, you wonder, Morten, whether it becomes a mental block as well. Do you think it does?
Sometimes you think, yeah, I think it does.
Service over.
They played a very good All England
six.
In March and got to the final as far as I remember. But lost it quite easily when they got to the final.
Yeah, second consecutive year they'd been in the All England final. So the Danes back level.
All.
Oh, low serve is short of the mark.
Service over. 7-all.
I think this is going to be a very, very tight match.
Me too. Oh, string's gone in Mogensen's racket now.
Yeah.
8-7.
But I'm telling you, the tension these two guys are playing with in their rackets is unbelievable. I was at the stringing bar and talked to one of my good friends, Mark, from England. And I picked one of those two rackets and I said, Mamma mia, they are tight. They said, yeah, it's unbelievable. They really play with tight rackets. So it doesn't take a lot before they break.
Yeah, missed time shot. Yeah. That's it, string's gone.
So! 9-7.
I'm not entirely convinced myself, Morten, about having rackets strung that tight, because the number of times that the Danes do break the strings in a match
And of course, virtually every time that they break a string, they lose the point.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure that they win enough points to compensate for that by having the extra tension in the rackets, because doubles is so much about placement of the shuttle rather than power.
Yeah, I agree with you. To a certain extent, I really agree with you. I don't think they gain that much extra by having them so tight. I'm sure they could go down on the tension of the rackets and still, you know, get the same power, but possibly more touch to the shuttles as well, and obviously not losing that many points on broken strings either.
Good flick serve. That was quick in there, so wasn't he, Endo?
10-9. Interval.
The Japanese pair of Hayakawa and Endo, who have the advantage at the mid-game interval. Just 2-point advantage.
Hvis vi kan trykke den ned i midten, så har de ikke nogen mængde.
Og når I kommer ind på dem, også har noget her, så
kan
kroppen væk henover, og så ind på kroppen af dem, ikke ud i siden. Okay?
Well, that's what you have to do when the strings are so tight and one goes. You have to just snip out all the strings to release the tension in the racket head, because otherwise the racket head can become a little bit distorted by the variation in the tension with that broken string. So he's not having a fit of anger there.
No, absolutely not. Absolutely not.
So what were the words of wisdom this time from Mr. Larson?
He wants to generate some pressure, power, attack straight down the middle of the court toward the body of the two players. That's in.
12-9.
Good variation in the smash there from Matthias Boelt, using the slice going across the body.
It's interesting because it's always been so good when Morgensen is at the back and Bo at the front of the court. But I think lately, the last year or so, we've been watching them. We've seen more and more often that Matthias Bo is doing quite well from the back of the court.
Yeah. Oh dear, that's not the best of serves. No, back level.
12-all. Do it.
Mathias Bo is into a good rhythm here on this serve, and he's very keen to maintain it. Good serve again.
Yeah, what a third shot, my goodness me.
Look at that, he's... I want to have 14, the shuffle. He did that before as well. He wants to keep this momentum as much as possible. And how many points is this so far? 5 points? 12-9 down?
Yeah. Oh, more strings gone. I'm going to keep a count of this. That's three now.
That's three,
13,
yes.
14.
Just applying the grip powder as well. It just makes the grip a little tacky.
Play.
Delightful interception, and lovely change of point, pace.
15-13.
Yeah, it's a good run for the Danish combination here. 12 down, 12-9 down, and now 15-13 up. I'm sure they're very delighted by that.
Service over, 14-15.
Once again.
So. 16-15.
Yes, I think we are witnessing a match very, very much focused on that service situation, as what we discussed so many times earlier. The serve, the return, and that third shot. And both players are really focusing on that. Look at that, hardly any rallies.
Yeah. 16-all.
But interesting though that because it's a slow stadium to play in, I'm still a little bit baffled that they are not flicking a few more services.
What, both pairs?
Both pairs, yes. That was fast and furious, wasn't it?
18,
very, very fast.
16.
I like the way Bo, having blocked the defence, immediately went forward to the net. But then look at his posture at the net there.
Yeah, then from there he's out of the equation.
Yeah. Was that another racket gone, or did he just put some grip powder on?
I think just grip powder.
Okay. It's a good serve. Very good attacking play from the
19,
Japanese combination.
16.
Yeah, just 2 points away from this opening game. And the Danes really have to find a few answers here now.
Pressurizing the left-handed Matthias Bo on his defense.
Game point 16.
So four game point opportunities for the Japanese pair. Oh, that was a good decision. Got out of the way in the end and let it drop long of that back line.
First game won by Hiroki Endo, Kenichi Hayakawa, 21-16.
21-16 confirms the umpire. 21 minutes of play. And Endo and Hayakawa are one game to the good.
Altså, du har en spadestil, hvor vi tager på ude, ja. Så tager vi ikke så meget.
Nej.
Vi skal prøve at være lidt mere skarpe, når ja. Vi selv sørger, men selvfølgelig mest, når vi returnerer, ja. Altså efterfølgende, vi stopper, men vi lige prøver lige at tage nogle huller.
Vi lægger alt ind til netmanden, når vi saver, ikke også? Der kommer virkelig meget ind, så netmanden, han skal være super klar, ikke også? Og så, når I modtager, ikke også, så specielt på Endo, gå hårdt på ham, ikke også? Op og sidde på ham, han er ikke så lang endnu.
Ja.
Vi må gerne få nogle lange med, få dem væk lidt.
Players, intervals are mandatory. Intervals mandatory. Please.
Yes, it certainly is. Interval is mandatory. Full 2 minutes will be taken.
Seconds.
Just quickly tell us what the Danish coach was advising.
The front player have to be extremely active. Really have to be in there. And when they get into these fast exchanges, they have to go forward because they're not winning enough of them. They really have to go all in when it comes into these exchanges.
Hayakawa. Endo.
And then they have to focus on not only on the return of serve, but also on
Second
their own
game.
Serve.
Low
They're
ball.
Not winning enough points
Play.
On own serve.
One low.
Oh, that's gone long.
Two
but that's
low.
What Jesper Larsen meant, you know. Opportunities and chances like that must be put away.
Service over. One, two.
You know, all the pace taken out of the shuttle by it hitting the top of the tape. Yeah, well worked by the Danes. Relentless attacking play.
2-all.
Yeah, it's very good attack, but what's doing the damage is the Japanese are not able to lift it long enough. It's getting too short every single time, so eventually the Danes are coming through.
Oh.
Yeah.
That is quick onto that from Hayakawa. Yeah.
3-2.
Pabo should never be able to get away with it unless obviously he clips the tape and that's it. But otherwise he would never be able to win that one. It's played from too low position.
Service fault called. Service racket over. Not pointing in a downward direction.
Four, 3.
Deep in the defensive stance. Endo. Look, he's pushed back. He's almost on the double service line as he tries to defend that. You know, Morten, I just sense, I know you've talked about the importance of the first three shots and the concentration by both these pairs on those crucial start to each and every rally. But I'm also getting the sense that the Danes need to dig deeper here. They need to work harder.
Seven, because four.
You know it's a slow haul in that it's difficult to time and put away their smashes. And it's almost as if when they do get into the rallies that they're not working to build the rally for the right opportunity. They're trying to put it away.
Really they want to finish it as quickly as possible.
Exactly. Shot like that.
Shots like that. On a few occasions here in the second game as well, you see that Matthias Bo is standing so close to the net that he's virtually covering nothing.
Yes.
Service over.
Well,
5.
I just think this is crucial for the Danes. If they want to win this match, I think they really have to start closing it down before the mid-game interval.
Yeah, the problem here is that Matthias Bo can't flick it again. Oh, he will not flick it again. Of course he can do it, but I don't think he will.
Because he was called a fault before.
Yes.
Yeah.
But that was a good serve. Really good serve.
Service over. 9-5.
It's interesting, you know, you were talking in the opening game about how the Danes always used to have their favourite formation of Bowe going forward to the net, where he was absolutely brilliant, and Morgensen at the back of the courts with a sensational smash, not necessarily the hardest, but his placement and his angle, absolutely brilliant.
Yes.
And it seems to me as if Bowe nowadays doesn't make such an impact when he goes forward in court. And maybe it's because of that, perhaps it's better that he goes back more.
Yeah, and what we saw at the World Championships in August in Copenhagen was that Carsten Mogensen was playing absolutely brilliantly from the front of the court. For the first time, I really thought that he made a huge difference in the matches they played from the front of the court.
Gone wide.
Service over. 7-10.
It's all good. What a great serve.
Yeah, that was a good serve.
Ten.
It certainly was. And another. Yeah, well worked.
9-10.
Level.
Yeah, 6-10 down.
Boy.
This is awesome. This is a perfect follow-up by Carsten Mogensen here. That was really, really well played.
Well, I don't think we need to translate that. I do apologize. Well, it seems to me as if Rione Manicki wants to move opponents at the back.
Altså hver eneste gang du spiller den ind til dem, og den er i den her højde, så kommer den tilbage, om man er netmand eller bagmand. Den kommer aldrig hårdt eller væk. Den kommer her hele tiden. Ja, også. Så når vi har lagt den der, så helt klar fremad i bagefter.
Well, we only caught the end of what Jesper Larsen was saying, but I want to focus actually at the moment on what Rione Manicki seemed to be saying to the Japanese pair. And I'm only guessing at
yes.
this, but yeah. he seemed to be indicating by his gestures, move the player at the back of the court from side to side.
Yeah, obviously that's that will really add on some major pressure on the two Danes that they have to attack from out of position.
Yeah, there he is. Originally from Indonesia, been living in Japan for many, many years. Always call good. Deliberately left that, did Bowe.
12-11.
Well inside that back line.
But it was a good run of points on his serve from 6-10, and that really kept the Danes in the match here. So very good serving by Matthias Bowe.
another string on. That's four.
13, 11.
You don't want to lose 21-19, 21-19 then, do you?
No, because that's your 4 points.
Yes.
Well, it would prove our theory, Morton.
It would.
Ooh.
They're considering.
And considering the challenge, thought better of 12, it.
13.
I thought it was a very, very good call by the line judge. It's difficult because we're sitting behind the court. Yeah, that's clearly it.
Yeah, you win.
Yeah, well done.
Yeah, well done.
Yeah, line judges have a difficult job. I have to say, they do wonderfully well.
They do, but I thought about you. I can understand his frustration. That was possibly 13. The most easy shot of them all.
Little stamp of frustration. The Danes go back into the lead. 8 of the last 11 points.
Service over, 14 all.
Seem to get caught in two 15, minds sometimes, doesn't 14. He, Matthias Bob, whether to defend forehand or whether to try backhand, and I think that was one of those occasions.
Yeah, he was a bit caught in that one, but interesting. As you say, I think the Japanese pair is directing as many as possible attacks towards Matthias Bob, but I also think the Danes are applying the same kind of tactics, just sort of applying it to Endo.
16, 14.
When the opportunity is there, I think they go for Endo quite a lot.
Goodness me.
That's well left. That is well left.
Service over.
But it proves my point. 16. I think three or four of these defensive shots were from Endo.
Yep, there. And again. And again.
But the first one was even a cross court, so there's four in a row.
Minds as to whether to leave it or not.
15.
By the time he decided to play it, he was a little late. Yeah.
Fifteen.
He's awfully deep in his defensive stance there, Matthias Bo.
But I think Carsten Mogensen could have helped him there.
Yeah.
Lifting to his own side. Mm.
That's nicely done.
Yeah, he's really stepping into it.
So it's over. 16-18.
Gone in Endo's racket.
Yep.
Gone to the front of the court. He's not. Oh, he thought about running off and changing
he
his
racket. He was in two minds. Yes.
Yeah. And his partner hit the perfect winner. The disguised drop shot.
So it's over. 19-16.
Boy.
Well, that was interesting. The umpire offering the Danes to go to the side of the court and towel down, and they said no. We want to play on.
So when it comes to 17 or 18, then they will ask to towel down. You wait. You wait. Let's see.
No, we might not get to that because the Japanese pair are only 2 points away from victory. Oh, clash of rackets. Yeah, well put away. From Carsten Mogensen.
So it's over.
He's not the biggest of athletes, is he? I mean, he's very slender in his build, but my goodness, he has a good smash.
Yeah, it's just like a whip. He's got such a nice technique to it.
Yeah.
Very, very nice.
Oh, there's another one gone. Another string gone.
Yeah, but he still scored the point, but you have to add it onto the list.
18, yep. 19.
Score is 5-1, as far as rackets are concerned. Oh, just 1 point the deficit. There's the damage one. Well, at least it was... I was going to say it's in the middle. In fact, there's both vertical and horizontal strings gone in that. Yeah.
But maybe that's what's kept it in. Mm.
So 1 point in it.
Nice serve.
Clever. Yeah, good rally. The Danes are so impressive when they're on the attack, when they're hitting in a downward direction. But physically, that's much more demanding.
Yeah, that was good play. So, once again, all level, 19 all. Yes, it did.
Oh, my goodness.
It did.
20.
Carsten had a similar one earlier in the match, and that stayed on the Danish side, but this one actually got over.
My goodness me. On a run of four straight points then, from 16-19 down. Now the Danes have an opportunity to level this match at one game or... Extraordinary. Five straight points.
and we're going to be treated to a third and a deciding game. One game all, 44 minutes. And what immense doubles we got on our hands here.
Så går vi rundt, og så brænder vi den af igen.
Ham tykker den. Det kan godt være ham den anden, han kan godt være ham den anden ikke, altså, men han får flere bolde over det defensiven, når vi står. Han er den anden, der laver fejlene.
Det er fint, når I angriber og går efter ham også. Det er som i servesituationen, der er Haikar klart skarper. Ja. Der er Indu, der han er altså ikke særlig skarp, så når vi kan lægge nogen sammen, så får vi noget at arbejde med bagefter.
Ja, men da jeg trækker mine saver ind på foden af ham der, Haikar, så kan han ikke bare løbe frem lige i forhånden. Ja. Altså, så skal han ind sådan den her.
Men det er alt for mega, det er, som I selv siger, det er tændingen, og det er at være klar på de der tredje bolde, ikke også, når vi har sadet. Og så er det også, når vi har modtaget, at når vi går op og modtager, så er vores bagmand og I selv, altså begge op med hovedet frem.
Så kan du have midt der, så kan du have midt der, der har sagt, der med på dyr, tændt ind, ikke? Det er med, der har sagt, der har sagt.
Lots of discussions going on.
Yeah.
Both sides.
Hvis du har feeling for det over i den side, det er så lidt den kryds over, hvor den.
Boy, seven.
Final game. Low wall. Play. Oh!
Well, that extraordinary run of five straight points to close out that second game by the Danes. Well, it means we are being treated to this decider. And Morten, you were noticing that both coaches were spending an awful lot of time with their players. And I think as far as the Japanese pair are concerned, I think this man, Rione Amanaki, as much as anything, was trying to get them to forget about that and forget about the missed chances, the missed opportunities, and just focus
on
totally.
To the next.
Yeah. What about the Danes?
Obviously very happy to win it. They liked the way, the commitment they had at the end. They were committed to every single rally and very focused, and obviously you can see that gave them 5 points, so happy with that. Once again, they emphasized that it's Endo that makes the mistakes the Japanese combination is making mistakes.
Yeah. Well, a service fault has been called on Hayakawa.
2-1.
Racket not pointing in a downward direction. Yeah, he's having a quick look up and at the replay. Now, what did I do wrong there?
Doesn't give him much.
No. It does seem that an awful lot of the time, whenever there's a flick serve, it's almost an automatic call of a fault from service judges, simply because of the technique you need to flick the shuttle. This is a good run.
Yeah, the Danes are really having a good start here. Excellent rally once again. Good interception by Bo, giving Carsten Mogensen a perfect chance here at the end. But this was good interception.
Terrible indecision from Endo. Should I play it? Should I play it? Oh. Half hearted attempt in the end. Yeah, look at the whole body language now of Kenichi Hawakaya. Despair. How did I miss that? Landed in. Well, we were actually discussing yesterday, weren't we, Morten, about whether there was a drift in this arena or not, and seeing that one land in as well, I wonder if it's playing a little bit slower, hitting towards that far side of the court as we look down.
It is. It is. I don't know. You don't know, and I haven't told you, but I have actually made notes. We have had almost 4 hours of play this afternoon. And just to indicate how slow this stadium is, there has been 10 shots out on the baseline. 10 shots in total. I talk about a clear or a lift. I'm not talking about these really fast, flat ones that ends way out. That's not what I'm talking. But, you know, normal shots that, you know, I'm going to lift this one, I'm going to play a clear or whatever. 10 shots.
In 4 hours.
In 4 hours. And 9 of them has been going out in one end and only 1 in the other.
So they've been going out this end.
Yes.
As we look down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Only 1 in the other end. Mm. It just shows how slow this stadium is, because we are talking about 10 shots. It's 2 handfuls in 4 hours of play. Oh, 3 hours and 45 minutes.
It wouldn't be unusual to see 10 shots going out in one match.
In one game.
Mm. Well, I hope we wouldn't see it in one game.
No, but I'm saying,
it
you
could
know, five each.
Yeah, very good point.
So I made small little notes here in the corner of my notepad.
Yeah.
That's a good shot. Yeah. Hayakawa here. Seven really good shot.
5-8.
What I liked about the shot was that it was played with a purpose into the. Not only it was flat, it was fast and all that, but also into the gap.
Yeah. Time that perhaps too big a swing at the net. You haven't really got time for that short, sharp motion of the racket head, usually suffices. That is delightful. That's two lovely shots from Hawakawa.
7-8.
Look at that, just brushes over the shuttle. And again, finding the space. That's what you were talking about, finding the gap.
Yes. Now, should the Danes get that shot back, it would mean that they're severely under pressure because they moved very much out of position.
Crikey. Good flick serve. Well, that's just blown my theory about the faults on the flick serves.
No, it happens a lot.
Yeah.
It does.
Yeah, it's excellent flick serve.
In all honesty, I think he chose that shot because of the strings. He's a little bit out of position and he doesn't want to hit it. On a few other occasions, he's been hitting full blast and the string's gone. And I think this time he chose not to do it because of what has happened in the past. It was the exact same position.
Yeah. Well, the Danes with the advantage here in the deciding game, 2-point advantage. Very quick to move to the other side of the court.
Og være så klar efter de selv har sat. Det er der, han bliver afgjort, ikke også? Ja. Udover det, så nu her, de får svært ved at løfte den væk. Der er et eller andet, der er forskel på siden af en eller anden årsag, fordi man angriber klart bedre herovre fra jeres side her. Ja. Så hurtig afvikling på dem, og så med frem, fordi de er svære for hen over herovre fra. Ja.
20 sekunder.
Se lige på nu. Så.
Ser noget i det.
Holder vi dem lige det der inde imellem, så kører du den ned, og så flytter den derfra.
Og vent til.
Well, that's interesting. One of the Danes releases all the tension in broken rackets, broken strings, by snipping them all out. The other one just leaves them as they are.
Yeah.
Well, that's a string gone, all right.
Yeah.
12-9.
That can prove to be crucial.
Yeah.
12-9, so much more appealing to the Danish than 11-10.
Long gone are the days when we used to repair rackets and replace strings.
Oh, yeah.
Complete restring nowadays.
Yeah, I remember when I was a kid, you know, we were comparing rackets and said, okay, how many repairs have you got in yours?
It was a competition, wasn't it?
Yeah, those were the days.
Oh dear, we're sounding like a couple of old fogies.
Yeah, we are, so.
Oh, that's nice. Oh, well taken. It's a good rally.
Service over. 10-12. So it's whistle at 13 pin.
Well, once again, very eager to pick up the shuttle after his lucky net cord. Couldn't have a little snooze with the Japanese players on court, could you, with their little battle cries before the rally?
They wake you up every time.
Oh, another wonderful net shot from the Danes, this time from Carsten Mogensen. And they've opened up a four-point cushion. 1 hour this match has been in progress. And I think it's far from decided.
Thank you.
No, this match has proved that 4 points is nothing.
Yeah.
Play. Service over. 11-14. Service over, 15-11.
Oh, certainly the luck with the net cord seemed to be with the Danes at the moment. Like one hitting the top of the tape, but falling back the Japanese player's side. She held that a long time, didn't he?
He did.
Well, they've really turned this match around, it would seem. The Danes, from that 16-19 deficit in the second game, having already lost the first, since then they've played with much more purpose and look far more aggressive and positive in their whole demeanour. Not just their style of play.
Yeah, they were 10-6 down as well in that second game.
Yes, indeed they were.
17-11.
And now it seems they are running away with it.
Just 3 points away from victory.
18-11.
Three-time former champions.
Yeah, Matthias Bo has really been serving well this match, I think. Very often when the Danes are having a run of points, he's the one that's serving.
Well, it's now or never as far as the Japanese pair are concerned. 18.
Carsten was saying, watch out for the flick. It's good microphones on that court.
Yeah. There we saw
13,
the defensive 18. Skills of Carsten Mogensen, and it was so good. There's no way they can get it down, and then look at that cross court setting off a nice attack for the Danes, but he missed it himself. I think the Danes are winning that challenge.
You thought it was out?
Yeah.
Well, I thought it was going out, but then when it actually landed, I had my doubts. So Hawkeye needs to tell us for sure. A good challenge.
Challenge unsuccessful.
Oh. No, you win.
One challenge remaining.
Yeah. No, I'm getting 14, confused.
18.
Yeah.
So the point to the Japanese pair.
It was calling, and
it was in.
And it was in.
You know,
15,
when the Danes were 18-12, Carsten Mogensen just kept defending and defending and defending.
Yep.
And I thought to myself, why on earth has he just changed the tactics? Why has he gone off the boil here? And all of a sudden now there's only 3 points in it. And it's believable. It's believable that the Japanese pair can catch back up. You can't afford to let off for one moment. And I just felt that the Danes perhaps did take their foot off the pedal, just slightly.
Yeah, but I think it's part of the tactic. If they stop, keep coming at them all the time, 19, they get used to it. They 15. Have to variate it now and again. And I think Carsten Mogensen, what he was doing was really clever, because he played such a good counter-attacking shot, and he actually set himself up very, very nicely. He missed it. Mm. But I think, you know, if you just attack.
Yeah, good point.
They get too used to it. And sometimes you have to play variations. And I think that's what he's trying to do. And as long as he keeps the pressure to himself,
16,
because his defense
19.
Is so strong, I think that he's got a point.
Mm.
But now we have the magic 16-19 again.
Mm.
Just reversed.
Oh, that's a shocker of a serve.
Yeah, that was not a good serve.
Got what it deserved. And now it's 4 match point opportunities for Matthias Bo and Carsten Mogensen. Opportunity will do. 21-16 in the deciding game.
just under an hour and 10 minutes. Well, they look to be on the brink of defeat at 16-19 down in the second game. But there we have confirmation of the score, 16-21.
21-19, 21-16. Thank you.
I'll let the umpire do the scoring for me. There we go, an hour and 9 minutes. And now Aboa Mogensen played 2-1-2 in Group B. So that victory for the three-time former champions Mathias Boa and Carsten Mogensen means that they topped the group, played 2-1-2. And of course the 3 and 4 in the group, who both lost their first matches yesterday, will play off later today. For the other group, sadly, the former world champions and defending champions here at the Super Series finals, Mohamed Hassan and Hendro Setiawan, retired in the first game of their match yesterday against Chai Biao and Hong Wei. So, in essence, there's only three left in Group A. Well, our next match features the former world champion. There she is, three-time former world junior champion as well.